It is another sad day, and I feel like the same story all over again, dealing with a little girl in the crossfire of a gun battle getting shot. She is still in the hospital right now recovering, and a very interesting, disgusting, horrible story to go along with it, that she is the sister or half-sister,
yes,
of a little girl that died in the same situation last year. C4 joining us to talk about it. And, you know, you heard this afternoon here on WBAL, the press conference, when they're talking about change and we need to do more, and I feel like it's a broken
record.
It's just
frustrating, Stacey.
Acting Commissioner Gary Tuggle did his best to try to present some type, we're going to the community, we're going to talk to people, but he stood there and said they've got no information from the community, they have no leads on what was the shooting of a five-year-old walking to the store with baby doll in hand, walking at 6 o'clock p.m. in a place where he acknowledged there are people that congregate in the corners. It's one of those areas where there are gatherings of individuals. We're not talking about midnight. We're talking about 6 o'clock dusk where people would be outside. And yet nobody saw anything. That's the frustrating part about this, Stacey. Look, we can have criticisms of the police department, state's attorney's office, the politicians. That's fair. But when nobody's coming forward to talk about the shooting of a five-year-old, that truly is a telltale sign of where our city is.
Yeah, people are just afraid to speak up.
But at the same time, though, I mean, sure, I understand retaliation. I understand, but when a five-year-old is shot, what on a human level doesn't reach you to try to protect a five-year-old?
Yeah, we heard today that the little girl was walking to the store,
yeah,
without parents, 5 years old, and a lot of people are criticizing
and
that.
And I understand that.
I get it, but this is in her very own neighborhood, and it's something
and
she does all the time.
She does all the time. The store owner even knew that she liked sunflower seeds and things like that, so he knew what. So this is not a situation where a child is just left unaccompanied or whatever. This is a walk to the store and probably a walk back home. I necessarily wouldn't do it with my children, but there's an area that everybody knows everybody. It's a place where everybody knows everybody. And I'm disgusted that we don't have any leads, and I'm going to continue to say that, in a situation where a child could have been killed.
So where do we go from here? I mean, we have a
good
new
question.
Police commissioner, you know, hopefully will be confirmed within a couple weeks.
Yeah, but no sense of urgency there, huh? Why don't we wait until January 28th to confirm this?
Why are they waiting now?
It's politics. It is the city council. I'm going to say, I said yesterday, throwing a temper tantrum because the mayor did not include them in this process. They're traveling down to Texas. They're going to go through all these hearings. It's not like we have approaching 300 homicides again this year and 700 non-fatal shootings, stuff we haven't seen ever in our history. Look, the citizens of Baltimore deserve better than this, Stacey. We deserve all of our leaders, quote unquote, to come together around the issue of violence, the same violence that shot this five-year-old.
Yet, again and again, we are hearing the same stories day after day. It might not be a five-year-old. It might be a
15-year-old. 84-year-old. How about an 84-year-old man in his car?
Exactly. And it's the same story over and over and over again.
Because we have all the oars aren't rowing in the same direction. For whatever political reason, this boat is over here. We're not all focused as we were. People talk about it all you want. Under Mayor Sheila Dixon, with her commission time, Fred Bielfeld, I'm talking 2009, 2010, 2011, we saw homicides under 200. We saw non-fatal shootings numbers under 500. Why? Because repeat violent offenders. They were focused on getting that group off the street, and we're not doing it.
So what can Joel Fitzgerald do day one? I mean, what
come
can
in,
he do?
Come in with a sense of urgency. I don't know what his plan is going to be, and we had Governor Larry Hogan on our show today talking about a federal government program, a strike force program, that is coming in with 12 different federal law enforcement agencies coming to the city. But a sense of urgency. We don't have that urgency right now. Okay, little girl got shot. Who's next one? I mean, Where's the swoop down on that community like we saw when Detective Sean Suter was shot? Swoop down, try to find the perpetrators and get them off the street.
Yeah, didn't they do a perimeter around the
neighborhood
immediately?
All of that. I'm just saying that's what's missing now,
wow,
that sense of urgency.
All right, C4 on every
Happy Thanksgiving
weekday,
to you.
You as well, 9 to 1 right here on WBAL.